Welcome to the video. Today we're back in Pembrokeshire, West Wales, a county filled with ancient megaliths, history and folklore. We're visiting Carreg Samson to take a close look at the stone and explore the history behind how it got its name and some other stories attributed to it. This megalithic monument sits in a meadow overlooking the beautiful Abercastle Harbour and the Irish Sea. On a clear day you can see the Preseli Hills, and apparently you also have sightline with another monument nearly 4 miles away, the unique and very jaunty Fist Samson. We didn't manage to capture this with the zoom on our camera, but we visited both sites and we'll have another video up soon, so please subscribe to get recommended of that. Its fat rounded capstone is perched on only 3 out of the 6 upright stones. This capstone's particularly interesting with its splashes of quartz throughout. In fact, 3 of the uprights also have this patchy finish, but the quartz is especially frequent on the capstone. Cadw classifies this site as a chambered tomb or dolmen and dates it to around 5,000 years old. According to Covlin, the site was excavated in 1968. This revealed 4 additional stone holes, one having supported a further chamber stone, the others indicating a possible passage leading off to the northwest. Slight traces of a covering cairn were found to the south, and it was shown that the monument had been raised over a pit 0.8 metres deep, filled with clay and stones. Finds included a small quantity of burnt bone, pottery and flints. The site is named Carreg Samson, meaning Samson's stone, because of an old legend that the Celtic Christian saint placed the capstone upon the standing stones using only his little finger. In the process, his finger was severed and it was buried nearby. But as this saint is said to have lived in the 5th century, the stones on this site had already been standing for thousands of years by this point. So this legend is likely a Christian adaptation of a much older traditional story. A short walk through the fields in which Carreg Samson lies will lead you down to the sea and over to a small island named Innis Castell, meaning Castle Island. Not much remains today of a castle on this island, but there's visible evidence of a promontory fort, a 30-metre square earthwork enclosure. Although its date and function are uncertain, this whole island contains evidence of development as a defined settlement, presumed to be from the pre-Roman Iron Age. Nearby this enclosure lies a mound known as the Grave of Samson's Finger. Some modern accounts suggest that Carreg Samson was also called the Grave of Samson's Finger, but we believe this to be a misinterpretation based on old maps. The modern antiquarian recounts a local legend saying that the capstone at Carreg Samson was flicked into place from the island. Could this be a clue that the island was a focus for the sighting of the stone? As we've mentioned, Carreg Samson is classified as a chambered tomb, although there's no direct evidence that this would have had a covering mound. Writings by Childs and Nash in 2007 say, excavation found there to have originally been a 2 metre long passage entrance, and there were 3 pits, 2 inside the chamber and 1 a metre outside. If there was a covering mound, it means the pits predate the cromlech, as the mound would have covered the area of the outside pit. This ties in with an increasingly popular theory that suggests many of these sites would not have originally been covered or used as tombs as previously thought, but rather that they were designed to stand out in their surroundings much as we see them today, as impressive displays of local skill and prowess, landmarks and meeting points used by nomadic tribes, if not something more spiritual or magical. Later generations adding smaller stones and mud to create the chambers that are evident at some sites, like Tinkinswood that we visited in our last video. We may not know what the original purpose was for these kinds of structures, but its importance in the landscape is clear, and its close proximity to others arranged in a similar way is something that we are researching for an upcoming video. Thanks for watching, and if you've enjoyed this video, please click a like or subscribe to let us know that we should carry on making more videos like this.